Auguste Bartholdi was a sculptor who came from the city of Colmar in Alsace. His most famous work became a gift from the people of France to the people of America in celebration of the first 100 years of the United States. Bartholdi called his statue Liberty Enlightening the World. But for the poor and huddled masses entering New York Harbor, the Statue of Liberty became a symbol and a beacon of hope. And so it has remained ever since.
Auguste Bartholdi was a sculptor, and this is the house where he lived. He did a lot of commemorative statues of the good and the great. Lots of them are still standing. In Colmar, here alone, 8 of them. He also did some allegorical works and some stunningly lifelike figures, frozen in time as if by this new invention that was the rage, photography. If he only had done that, his name probably would have long been forgotten. But Auguste Bartholdi's most famous work was created here. It started as a series of sketches, then a small terracotta figurine still up there on the second floor. It was meant by Bartholdi as an allegory for la liberté éclairant le monde. For the rest of the world, it's always been known as the Statue of Liberty. Now, as everybody knows, the Statue of Liberty, which is probably the best known icon in the world, was a gift from the French people to the American people. It also was to celebrate the first centennial of the independence of the United States. How Bartholdi's vision got from that small terracotta figure created here in Colmar to the 152-foot high steel and copper marvel sitting atop its pedestal on Bedloe's Island is an epic story in itself. It involves great names of the day like Viollet-le-Duc, Gustave Eiffel, Victor Hugo, Joseph Pulitzer. It celebrates more than the enlightenment that Bartholdi imagined. As everybody knows, anybody who's ever entered the New York Harbor, it is a symbol of hope, the symbol of hope. And as a Frenchman who gazed at it in wonder and awe, let me just say this, let it stand forever.